It's Matt Jeremy again, part three, Friday the 9th, July 9th, specifically. I like to put the date in. It helps us keep track of videos. We do an average of about, how many do a week? You know, about 30 new ones a week or more, sometimes more, about 30 a week on average now. Yeah. But we just had some more ideas. We were just talking about, like, at the end of the last video, spreading out, you know, how you use your mind to spread things, spread vibes out to people. It's basically, let me touch on this, it's about visualization, but you have to see that light coming out of you and going out into other people in your mind. It doesn't have to be the you sitting there physically. You can have another you in your mind with that person, send another part of you out. Basically see yourself standing next to whoever it is, wherever it is. But you have to do it with absolute knowledge. There can't be any doubt that it's working. You can't sit there and like, well, I hope it works. Maybe this will do some good. And, you know, you can't think like that. Just you have to know it's working. Be like, but there's no doubt at all. There can't be even an iota of doubt. You have to be like, well, it's working, so just be like, well, we got to do the job. You have to heal people up.
Yeah, like, you know, say, like, you send the vibes. You can send vibes to more than just one person, too. I mean, if you just kind of think of it in your mind, you know, I'm send out the good vibes to one person.
Yeah.
Send out the good vibes. You know, everybody can, you know, you can really affect a lot of people, you know, intentionally and unintentionally with your vibes, but especially when you're sending out good vibes, you know, you can definitely do it to more than one person.
Let me explain. I think I might have thrown in the story a few days ago, but it bears repeating if I have. Like, I'll give an example about the power of sending energy. Mm-hmm. Like, the other day, I was out, I went to work. I just gotten up, getting ready to get in the shower. I was on the computer checking the email before I got in the shower, playing with the cats for a minute, my cats. But anyway, I had something to tell me. I decided to go to work using my mind in the interim to get some work done, clearing up people's energies, bringing light in their energies, making them feel better, people I knew and stuff. Even people I don't know that were around people I knew. So took my mind out there and started working, clearing up, sending energy into people, cleaning their vibes up. I went in the shower. I was in the shower continuing to do it. So I tell you, the moment I got in the shower, the phone was just ringing off the hook. And some messages were coming in on Facebook. Text messages were coming in. And it was coming from people that I'd just been sending vibes to. Then some of them were people I hadn't heard from in a couple months. But suddenly, there they are, you know.
Oh, yeah.
There's no coincidence, you know, that these people called right after I finished, you know. Because they've just been receiving stuff from me.
You can do a lot of good work, just from your house or your home.
From your mind.
From your bed, wherever.
Driving down the street.
Anywhere you want. Just, you know, like you're driving down the road and you see people walking by. You can imagine yourself sending them good vibes. Well, it's not imagination. You're sending them good vibes. Each and everyone can be affected by that vibe. Just as long as you believe in yourself that you're sending them out. You know, you really have to...
got to believe all that way. It can't be... I mean, I'm saying no doubt at all.
Yeah.
I mean, I got to emphasize that. There can't be even a millisecond or millisecond of doubt. Not even one question about it. It just... you just have to know that you're affecting them. Know that you're powerful and you're using your power on them. And then it'll become true. It'll happen.
You'll lighten up yourself, and you'll be like,
you'll be healed yourself. You might feel tired for a minute. Now, let me give you a little thing about that.
Yeah.
You'll feel tired. You know, because that's another way you know when it works. You'll feel once you do it. Like if you're clearing out heavy vibes, negative vibes in people, or sadness and stuff. Like, it can drag you. You'll feel dragged after you finish. Your body will feel real heavy, your physical body. You might have a little headache and just dragging along because you've been outputting energy. That's how you know you really did it. That's one way to put it. But right. Then it'll come back to you. It'll lighten you up. You'll lighten up real quick.
Yeah, I can see the smile on your face and everything. It's like, oh, I've done good.
It'll bounce back real quick.
That's also that no doubt thing. You can't have doubt. Spreading vibes is also something that will give back, you know, karmically or, you know, some way. You know,
it will come back.
I wanted to stress on the word karma. Some people don't believe in karma.
But karma is just another way to say when you do the others, you do to yourself.
Right, you know, just like you know, if you judge others, you will be judged. Yeah.
It's just another word. It's a older, it's an ancient language word, maybe from Eastern Asia.
But yeah, and I think it's
the Bible even talks about karma. This is different words.
Yeah, it's just
what you do
words.
To others, you know.
I mean, I think it's in all texts, especially when it comes down to spiritual teachers, that, you know.
It's always there.
Yeah, what you do comes back to you, somehow in equal age, shape, and form.
That's the truth of the universe. That's the law of the universe itself, no matter what. No matter if you believe it or not, it's still happening to you.
Yeah, and when we go one step further, is it happens in this life, the next life, and the life after that.
Now, that's something a lot of people don't know about. It's going to be happening. Yeah, even if like you feel like, no, I got away with this and that, nothing happened. Believe me, it's coming back. In the next physical life you live, it's coming. It might be 1,000, 2,000 years from now even. It might be on another planet even, in another life as another alien form. It could be that you're going to pay for it that way, but it will. You will be rewarded or you will pay.
Yeah, it will come back to you.
So,
you
can't avoid it.
Nothing to be afraid of, but just...
It's just the law of the universe.
The universe. That's, I would say the law of the land, but...
Either way to put it.
You know. Because I don't think it stops here just on Earth, you know. I think if the infinite goes into the stars and beyond, you know, planets, other forms of life, you know. Plants. One thing I always thought was funny, that vegetarians, no offense to vegetarians, they don't want to eat animals, but except they're eating live plants. Vibes go into that too.
Yeah, plants are living too. They have spirits in them. Trees too. You're cutting down trees for these morning papers or whatever.
Yeah,
we're writing on paper now, but I mean,
it's
stuff
like,
there's better ways to do it than cutting down trees. We could talk about that in another video. People grow hemp. Hemp is where paper used to come from anyway.
Yeah, rope too. Yeah.
Rope, all clothes. Clothes made with hemp are better quality than made from cotton.
Yeah, they're probably cheaper to make too.
Yeah, it's a lot cheaper.
But we'll
talk about that another time. We could talk a lot about social issues and stuff like that. We'll get to that.
Right.
Well, let's throw in this, like we were talking about. I've just gone out to the car to get my hair brushed. So you see how picky I am about my hair by now. I'm always thinking of brushing my hair. We haven't done this in a while, but like we have so many. I want to say like we live in, as you know, in Richmond, Virginia. For those of y'all out of state, you know.
Yeah.
And we do stuff out of state for people. If the people need to talk to the other side, for other people, other states, other countries. But we tend to concentrate on local things here. People we know. A lot of times, people we don't even know. Most of the time, that's what it is. People didn't even know in life, well, they'll die, and then we'll see them. And then they want to reach out to y'all, you know?
Yeah, they just start coming through.
And they start coming through.
We've had a lot of people.
Lots of them.
You know?
Lots, you know? And we mainly deal with people who've been hurt. That's our thing, our concentration. We deal with people who've died violently. That's the main thing we've been doing lately. We try to do that.
They seem to need a lot of help.
They need a lot of help in that situation. Because they got cut off, they feel like they got cut off so suddenly, and the families, of course, and friends are going through. We know y'all are having a hard time.
Yeah.
But
and we want to help you too.
We wanted to make a list here. We have a lot of them that come through, and sometimes I know our website, the way it's organized, they got some videos on YouTube. There's some on MySpace. There's some on Facebook, and not all the videos are on every site. But there's a lot of people that have come through from the Richmond area, so I want to list out some of them. You know, I felt something, the infinite was kind of pushing me to do that. It came from the spirit, that idea, while I was out in the car getting my brush. It just appeared in my mind instantly. So when ideas appear like that, I know it came from the infinite. But we have so many, like maybe it's you, somebody you know, maybe a friend of yours has come through and you didn't know. We just wanted to say it to you. And if y'all want to contact us and talk to us about anything, someone who hasn't come through, we'll gladly do it for you. As you know, we don't charge anybody a dime, a penny, and nothing. Like, we do it with out of love for y'all. But let's think of who's come through. We need to list some people. Who has come through like that? Let's list them out.
Well, we have Rashawn come through.
Rashawn, yeah. Oh, yeah. That was that dude from Peter.